Welcome to Deploying Changes Using Change Sets, the last in the Release Management from Sandbox to Production series. These videos explain the basics of managing the development and release of customizations on the Force.com platform. In the sandbox, AW Computing's IT team created a new warehouse application that includes a tab and a custom object. With testing completed, it's time for Aaron, the administrator, to move all of the new components from sandbox to production using change sets. Change sets are a point-and-click tool that let you move configuration changes from one organization to another, in this case, from sandbox to production. We're logged in to the production organization as Aaron. So let's start by changing the deployment settings to allow a deployment connection from the sandbox to the production organization. Deployment connections are automatically created between related organizations when a sandbox is created, but organizations can't send or receive change sets until the connection between them has been authorized. If you're using Salesforce Lightning Experience, click the cog to access the setup pages. From Quick Find, search for Deployment Settings, and click Edit beside the sandbox connection. To allow the sandbox to deploy change sets to the production organization, we select Allow Inbound Changes and click Save. Now let's log in as Aaron to the sandbox and create an outbound change set. Use Quick Find to locate outbound change sets. Click New. We'll enter a name to help us identify the change set and a description of the changes it contains. Now let's add the new components to the change set. We created an application, a custom object, and a tab, so we can use the drop-down list to search for those components and then add them to the change set. We need to repeat this for each type of component. As you can see, we just added our three components. Sometimes you'll create objects that contain or depend on other objects. Click View Add Dependencies and then select the top checkbox to select all dependent components. Then click Add to Change Set. Notice that this adds the fields of the custom object, which were not automatically added with the object, along with the list view and page layout. Aaron wants this app to be immediately visible to all profiles on production who have permissions. In this case, the system administrator and contract manager profiles. To move the field level security setting for the merchandise object, click Add Profiles and select the system administrator and contract manager profiles. When you add a profile to a change set, only the profile settings that relate to the components are included. Click Add to Change Set. In addition to users with the contract manager profile, Aaron wants the app to be visible to a small group of users who are assigned to the Manage Merchandise Permission Set. So how do we do that? Simply click Add and select the Manage Merchandise Permission Set. When you add a permission set to a change set, make sure you also add the components it affects. In this case, the warehouse app, merchandise object, and fields. It looks like everything is ready, so click Upload and select the production organization. A change set may take a little while to upload. You'll be notified by email as soon as the upload completes. We'll switch over to the production organization now. An outbound change set from another organization appears as an inbound change set in this organization. From Quick Find, let's navigate to Inbound Change Sets. You can see that the change set is waiting for us. We can validate the new components in production to simulate the deployment and catch any potential errors. In this case, everything works as expected, so we're ready to commit the changes to the production organization. We click Deploy, choose any test that we want run as part of the validation, and then OK on the pop-up. After the changes have been deployed, we can see the new warehouse application in the App Picker and both the Merchandise tab and Custom Object. And because we deployed the profile permissions also, all of the components are immediately visible to all system admins and contract managers in the production organization. To take advantage of the Manage Merchandise Permission Set, however, we must assign the permission set to the relevant users in the production organization. When you move permission sets from one organization to another, you must reassign the permission set to users in the new organization. Finally, to complete the release management process, Aaron refreshes the developer sandbox before work on the next customization begins. For more information about release management, watch all of the videos in this series, or search for these topics and help. We also have a development lifecycle guide at developer.salesforce.com. Thanks for using Salesforce.